All right, well, let's go down in the rain.
Here we go.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Sister, on this most sacred night in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over, sons and daughters scattered to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial, over death and living with him, our minds made pure, we may attain festivities of unending splendor through Christ our Lord. By his holy most may the light of Christ rising in glory dispel the darkness.
Okay.
Oh.
Take that feet off.
No, I want to get to the front. No, here?
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Just one out. Put it down. It's out. Can you use it?
Go ahead. The cardinal lights first.
Okay, I'm sorry. Cup it.
Go to the break. The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah, I'm gonna have over the hill and if you want to do a few more, you can do the front.
Do I? What would you say?
If you want to do them.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Exalt, let them exalt the hosts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad as glory floods her, ablaze with light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of His glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ our Lord, His Son, His only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, and pouring out His own dear blood, wiped clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These then are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to his holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Our birth would have been no gain had we not been redeemed. Oh, wonder of your humble care for us. O love, O charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave you gave away your son. O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. Oh, happy fault that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer. Oh, truly blessed night, worthy alone to know the time and hour when Christ rose from the underworld. This is the night of which it is written, the night shall be as bright as day. Dazzling is the night for me and full of gladness. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen and joy to mourners, drives out hatred, fosters concord, and brings down the mighty. On this, your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. But now we know the praises of this pillar, which glowing fire ignites for God's honor. A fire into many flames divided, yet never dimmed by sharing of its light. For it is fed by melting wax, drawn out by mother bees to build a torch so precious. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth and divine to the human. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets. Christ your Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed his peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Everyone, blow out the candle and put it aside.
Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us extinguish our candles and listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his people, and in these, the last days, has sent his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption.
Lectura del libro del Génesis. En el principio creó Dios el cielo y la tierra. La tierra era soledad y caos, y las tinieblas cubrían la faz del abismo. El Espíritu de Dios se movía sobre la superficie de las aguas. Dijo Dios: que exista la luz. Y la luz existió. Vio Dios que la luz era buena, y separó la luz de las tinieblas. Llamó a la luz día y a las tinieblas noche. Fue la tarde y la mañana del primer día. Dijo Dios: que haya una bóveda entre las aguas que separe unas aguas de otras. E hizo Dios una bóveda y separó con ella las aguas de arriba de las aguas de abajo. Y así fue. Llamó Dios a la bóveda cielo. Fue la tarde y la mañana del segundo día. Dijo Dios: que se junten las aguas de debajo del cielo en un solo lugar y que aparezca el suelo seco. Y así fue. Llamó Dios tierra al suelo seco y mar a la masa de las aguas. Y vio Dios que era bueno. Dijo Dios: verdee la tierra con plantas que den semilla y árboles que den fruto y semilla según su especie sobre la tierra. Y así fue. Brotó de la tierra hierba verde que producía semilla según su especie, y árboles que daban fruto y llevaban semilla según su especie. Y vio Dios que era bueno. Fue la tarde y la mañana del tercer día. Dijo Dios: que haya lumbreras en la bóveda del cielo que separen el día de la noche, señalen las estaciones, los días y los años, y luzcan en la bóveda del cielo para iluminar la tierra. Y así fue. Hizo Dios las dos grandes lumbreras, la lumbrera mayor para regir el día y la menor para regir la noche. Y también hizo las estrellas. Dios puso las lumbreras en la bóveda del cielo para iluminar la tierra, para regir el día y la noche, y separar la luz de las tinieblas. Y vio Dios que era bueno. Fue la tarde y la mañana del cuarto día. Dijo Dios: agítense las aguas con un hervidero de seres vivientes y revoloteen sobre la tierra las aves bajo la bóveda del cielo. Creó Dios los grandes animales marinos y los vivientes que en el agua se deslizan y la pueblan, según su especie. Creó también el mundo de las aves, según sus especies. Vio Dios que era bueno y los bendijo diciendo: sean fecundos y multiplíquense. Llenen las aguas del mar, que las aves se multipliquen en la tierra. Fue la tarde y la mañana del quinto día. Dijo Dios: produzca la tierra vivientes según sus especies, animales domésticos, reptiles y fieras según sus especies. Y así fue. Hizo Dios las fieras, los animales domésticos y los reptiles, cada uno según su especie. Y vio Dios que era bueno. Dijo Dios: hagamos al hombre a nuestra imagen y semejanza, que domine a los peces del mar, a las aves del cielo, a los animales domésticos y a todo animal que se arrastra sobre la tierra. Y creó Dios al hombre a su imagen. A imagen suya lo creó. Hombre y mujer los creó. Y los bendijo Dios y les dijo: sean fecundos y multiplíquense. Llenen la tierra y sométanla. Dominen a los peces del mar, a las aves del cielo y a todo ser viviente que se mueve sobre la tierra. Y dijo Dios: he aquí que les entrego todas las plantas de semilla que hay sobre la faz de la tierra y todos los árboles que producen fruto y semilla para que les sirvan de alimento, y a todas las fieras de la tierra, a todas las aves del cielo, a todos los reptiles de la tierra, a todos los seres que respiran. También les doy por alimento las verdes plantas. Y así fue. Vio Dios todo lo que había hecho y lo encontró muy bueno. Fue la tarde y la mañana del sexto día. Así quedaron concluidos el cielo y la tierra con todos sus ornamentos, y terminada su obra, descansó Dios el séptimo día de todo cuanto había hecho. Palabra de Dios.
La tierra sobre sus cimientos y no vacilará jamás. La cubriste con el manto del océano y las aguas se posaron sobre las montañas. Envía tu espíritu, Señor. Los manantiales sacas los ríos para que fluyan entre los montes. Junto a ellos habitan las aves del cielo y entre las fondas se oye su canto. Desde tu morada riegas los montes y la tierra se sacia de tu acción fecunda. Haces brotar hierba para los ganados y forraje para los que sirven al hombre. Envía tu Espíritu, Señor, y renueva la faz de la tierra. ¿Cuántas son tus obras, Señor? Y todas las hiciste con sabiduría. La tierra está llena de tus criaturas. Bendice, alma mía, al Señor. Envía tu Espíritu, Señor, y renueva la faz de la tierra.
Oremos. Dios Todopoderoso Eterno, que en todas las obras de tu amor te muestras admirable, concede a quienes han redimido comprender que el sacrificio de Cristo, nuestra Pascua, en la plenitud de los tiempos, es una obra más maravillosa todavía que la misma creación del mundo, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. And you, lift up your staff and with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God who had been leading Israel's camp now moved and went around behind them, the column of cloud also leaving the front, took its place behind them, so that it came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed, without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind through the night, and so turned it into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit. All Pharaoh's horses and chariots and charioteers went after them, right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of the fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force a glance that threw it into a panic. And he so clogged their chariot wheels that they could hardly drive. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head on toward the sea when the Lord hurled them into its midst. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped, but the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. "I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea." The word of the Lord.
Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. I will sing to the Lord. Glorious his triumph. Horse and rider he has thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength, my song, my salvation. This is my God, and I extol him. My Father's God, and I give him praise. The Lord is a warrior, the Lord is his name. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory. The chariots of Pharaoh he hurled into the sea. The flower of his army is drowned in the sea. The deeps hide them, they sank like a stone. Your right hand, Lord, glorious in its power. Your right hand, Lord, has shattered the enemy. The people you have redeemed pass by. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. You will lead them and plant them on your mountain, the place, O Lord, where you have made your home. the sanctuary, Lord, which your hands have made. The Lord will reign forever and ever. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory.
Let us pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in the splendor even of our day, for what you bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution by the power of your right hand, now you bring about as the salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lectura del libro del profeta Ezequiel. En aquel tiempo me fue dirigida la palabra del Señor en estos términos. Hijo de hombre, cuando los de la casa de Israel habitaban en su tierra, la mancharon con su conducta y con sus obras. Como inmundicia fue su proceder ante mis ojos. Entonces descargué mi furor contra ellos. Por la sangre que habían derramado en el país y por haberlo profanado con sus idolatrías. Los dispersé entre las naciones y anduvieron errantes por todas las tierras. Los juzgué según su conducta, según sus acciones los sentencié. Y en las naciones a las que fueron, desacreditaron mi santo nombre, haciendo que de ellos se dijera, este es el pueblo del Señor, y ha tenido que salir de su tierra. Pero por mi santo nombre, que la casa de Israel profanó entre las naciones donde llegó, me he compadecido. Por eso, dile a la casa de Israel, esto dice el Señor. No lo hago por ustedes, casa de Israel. Yo mismo mostraré la santidad de mi nombre excelso, que ustedes profanaron entre las naciones. Entonces, ellas reconocerán que yo soy el Señor, cuando por medio de ustedes les haga ver mi santidad. Los sacaré a ustedes de entre las naciones. Los reuniré de todos los países y los llevaré a su tierra. Los rociaré con agua pura y quedarán purificados. Los purificaré de todas sus inmundicias e idolatrías. Les daré un corazón nuevo y les infundiré un espíritu nuevo. Arrancaré de ustedes el corazón de piedra y les daré un corazón de carne. Les infundiré mi espíritu y los haré vivir según mis preceptos y guardar y cumplir mis mandamientos. Habitarán en la tierra que les di a sus padres.
Ustedes serán mi pueblo y yo seré su Dios. Palabra de Dios.
Como busca la sierva corrientes de agua, my soul longs for you, my God. Como busca la sierva corrientes de agua, my soul longs for you, my God. Mi alma tiene sed de Dios, del Dios vivo. Cuando entraré a ver el rostro de Dios, como busca la sierva corrientes de agua, my soul longs for you, my God. Como marchaba la cabeza del grupo hacia la casa de Dios, entre cantos de júbilo y alabanza, en el bullicio de la fiesta. Como busca la sierva corrientes de agua, my soul longs for you, my God. Envía tu luz y tu verdad, que ellas me guíen y me conduzcan hasta tu monte santo, hasta tu morada. Como busca la sierva corrientes de agua, my soul longs for you, my God. Que yo me acerque al altar de Dios, al Dios de mi alegría, que te dé gracias al son de la cítara, Dios, Dios mío. Como busca la sierva corrientes de agua, my soul longs for you, my God.
Oremos. Dios inmutable poder y eterna luz, mira propicio el admirable misterio de la Iglesia entera. Realiza serenamente, en virtud de tu eterno designio, la obra de la humana salvación. Que todo el mundo vea, reconozca que los caídos se levantan que se renueva lo que había envejecido, y que por obra de Jesucristo todas las cosas concurran hacia la unidad que tuvieron en el origen. El que vive y reina por los siglos de los siglos.
Amen. I don't need them. I might already.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Oremos. Dios nuestro, que haces resplandecer esta noche con la gloria de la resurrección del Señor, aviva en tu iglesia el espíritu de adopción filial, para que renovados en cuerpo y alma, nos entreguemos fielmente a tu servicio. Por nuestro Señor Jesucristo, tu Hijo, que vive y reina contigo en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, y es Dios por los siglos de los siglos.
Amen. A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Hallelujah.
El Señor esté con ustedes. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Salome, bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. Very early, when the sun had risen on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. On entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting at the right side, clothed in a white robe, and they were utterly amazed. He said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, the crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." Transcurrido el sábado, María Magdalena, María la madre de Santiago y Salomé compraron perfumes para ir a embalsamar a Jesús. Muy de madrugada, el primer día de la semana, a la salida del sol se dirigieron al sepulcro. Por el camino se decían unas a otras, "¿Quién nos quitará la piedra de la entrada del sepulcro?" Al llegar, vieron que la piedra ya estaba quitada, a pesar de ser muy grande. Entraron en el sepulcro y vieron a un joven vestido con una túnica blanca, sentado en el lado derecho, y se llenaron de miedo. Pero él les dijo, "No se espanten. Buscan a Jesús de Nazaret, el que fue crucificado. No está aquí. Ha resucitado. Miren el sitio donde lo habían puesto. Ahora vayan a decirle a sus discípulos y a Pedro. Él irá delante de ustedes a Galilea. Allí lo verán como él les dijo." Palabra del Señor.
Mis hermanos y hermanas en Cristo, velar en la noche es esperar con esperanza. En esta noche, la noche santa de Pascua, estamos velando con toda la iglesia extendida por toda la tierra, escuchando las esperas, los anhelos de tantos hombres y mujeres, los que han precedido nosotros. Desde la creación del mundo, gente que tenía sed por un sentido de la vida que va más allá de las cosas y más aún, más allá de la muerte. en esta noche por la resurrección de Cristo, Dios responde a todos los anhelos de seres humanos como nosotros. Y por nuestro bautismo hemos compartido la muerte para que vivamos con Él. En esta noche, en esta vela, hermanos y hermanas aquí de la comunidad, va a pasar por las aguas de bautismo, muriendo así, a pecado, para vivir con la dignidad de hijos y hijas de Dios, hermanos y hermanas del resucitado. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, a friend of mine once interviewed a very famous novelist. He asked him about the experience of growing old because the gentleman was now in his 80s. So he thought about it. What was it like to get old? And he replied, "You feel like you're eating breakfast every 15 minutes." If you don't understand that, trust me, you will. Because time is funny. And when we were kids, things couldn't come fast enough. Like Christmas, like our birthday, like summer vacation. For most of us, that clock begins to accelerate as we grow older. As the years pass, we understand what the Latins said, tempus fugit, time flies, time flees. How often we ask ourselves, where does the time go? But whatever our age, we don't like to wait, especially for what is important. I imagine most of us here have cried out to God, "You could get rid of all this waiting if you wanted." Why the delay of 6 weeks before Easter? How does this Easter celebration make up for all that waiting? Brothers and sisters, we must wait for our slow selves to take it all in. We must bide our time. As if to illustrate this fact, the very length of this celebration this evening, this vigil, makes us wait and wait. The blessing of the new fire and the lighting of the paschal candle is followed by a number of readings from Scripture. Here, tonight, and in many of our parishes, thanks be to God, men and women will be baptized and come into full communion in the church. I recall during my years as Archbishop of Indianapolis, one year when one parish celebrated 50 baptisms. They served breakfast at the end of the vigil. Tonight, patience is the name of the game. Maybe for the same reason that Jesus made Mary and Martha wait until he called their brother Lazarus from the tomb. It makes our souls wait to believe. So very long, our heavy eyelids remind us. But salvation history is long, too. Tonight, the readings tell it in sequence as we struggle to stay focused, attentive, or even awake. How God created and blessed us. How he called on and counted on Abraham. How he rescued the Hebrew people as they ran away from their captors in the desert journey and later would run away from God, too. how for a brief moment God lost his patience and turned away, but then with enduring love took his people back, offering water to the thirsty and grain to the poor. God seems to be asking throughout this long history, are you able to trust this? How much do you trust me? Be my people, and I will be your God, he keeps saying. And then we listen to the gospel. At least Mark's account of the resurrection of Christ does not make us wait too long. Of the four gospels, Mark uses the fewest words to describe what happened during that night, that first day of the week. The women find the tomb empty, and an angel stationed there announces to them what had happened. They are told to proclaim the good news to Peter and the disciples in order to prepare them for a reunion with them in Galilee. If we had read one more verse, we would find out that in Mark's gospel, the women did nothing. They were too frightened. Tonight, our celebration is filled with very vivid images, a light that is greater than darkness, bread broken and a cup shared. But as I prepared this reflection, another image kept intruding in my head. It was things that I'd seen on mountaintops and in vast desert wastes, huge disks pointed at the night sky, listening, waiting, hoping they might hear the sound, the trace of the cry of a newly born universe. Those antennas keep vigil in hope, listening and waiting. Brothers and sisters, do you suppose that vigil keeping is a natural condition of the human heart? Because when we're unhampered by distractions and petty anxieties that can shackle us, our hearts probe beyond the routine. They look beyond the day-to-day life that we all live in search of something or in search of someone. Instants of awe, like the birth of a child or the first time we see the sea, as well as moments of intense loss, rip our spirits open and prod us to ask why. As long as that question remains a flowing river and not the dead sea of self-pity, our hearts keep vigil, watching and waiting. That's why I believe if Christmas is for kids, Easter is for grown-ups. If it is true that the magic of Christmas holds special appeal for children and for that famous child that lives inside each one of us, Easter speaks to adults. An adult has lived long enough to sense that the world is not our creation and that the horizon is no longer open-ended. What is more, the passage of time leaves two bequests to us, memory and death. An adult has lived long enough to lose something or lose someone. The vigil of Easter begins not in the quiet of this Saturday night, but on Thursday night in an agony of doubt and continues through Friday, the day of the cross. And refusing to be banished by any sort of overly sweet piety, memory and death sit beside us on the night of Easter. Tonight, more than any other night, our hearts hope to go beyond the trivial and discover what's real. The world is filled with spirits, be they haunting resentments, gut-wrenching losses, or nagging reminders of our own mortality. Sometimes benevolent, often malicious, these spirits seek to have the final word in our lives. At Easter, our spirits keep vigil, listening and hoping for more. On this night, there are ancient rhythms abroad, echoes that emanate from the beyond the dawn of human existence. They speak of the judgment of a creator who found everything that had been made to be very good. They whisper of a promise made to an elderly man and his incredulous wife that their offspring would be as numerous as the stars of heaven or grains of sand at the seashore. They recall a people still stupefied by their miraculous escape from slaughter, singing a new song to the Lord. On this night, the story leads the vigilant heart finally to join the women at the entrance of the tomb. Peering inside, one can make out the burial shroud and the cloth that covered his face, unmistakable evidence of the agony of Thursday and the defeat of Friday, but evidence that suffering and defeat do not have the final word. The empty tomb has the final word. One supposes that the men and women, the children and young adults who will be baptized this evening, have looked into that tomb and believe that Jesus is alive. Whatever else may lie before them, tonight they profess that suffering and death will not have the final word in their lives. Like us tonight, they will eat with and drink with Jesus after his resurrection. Brothers and sisters, though the fire we lit at the beginning of the celebration is now nothing more than embers, something has been enkindled tonight. A light more faithful than the morning star, which never sets. Jesus has come back from the dead and shed his peaceful light on humanity, the same light that embraces women and men forever. But this night, it embraces the men and women across this archdiocese who will be reborn in baptism. Brothers and sisters, this is the light we've been hoping for. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. With joy, let us keep the feast.
The elect and the godparents calmly, kindly come forward. Los elegidos y sus padrinos pueden acercarse. Harold Michael Ludwin, Angelina María Peña, Brandon Israel Piña, Daviana Paulette Vallejo, Dylan Josué Basantes, Edna Cristina Alberanga, Edward Gael Yáñez, Emily Nicole Canales, Fernando Javier Chiqui, Fran Magnus Gustav Bin, James Alexander Molina, Jaden Jacques, Jaden Jael Peñafiel, Julacy Ruby Bisney, Kenzie Marieth Molina, Kiara Aileen Rosero, Mateo Samuel Bravo, Naomi Sofia Poma. Everyone, please stand.
Dearly beloved, with one heart and one soul, let us by our prayers come to the aids of these brothers and sisters, Aaron Michael Ludwin, Angelina Maria Peña, Brandon Israel Pina, Daviana Paulette Vallejo, Dylan Josue Basantes, Edna Cristina Alvarenga, Edward Gael Yanez, Emily Nicole Canales, Fernando Javier Chiqui, Frank Magnus Gustav Beam, James Alexander Molina, Yedan Yaques, Yedan Yael Penafiel, Hulesi Ruby Vishnai, Kenzie Marieth Molina, Kiara Aileen Rosero, Mateo Samuel Bravo, Naomi Sofia Poma, these in their blessed hope, so that as they approach the font of rebirth, the Almighty Father may bestow on them all his merciful help.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us.
Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Holy angels of God,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us. Pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene,
pray for us.
Saint Stephen,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch,
pray for us.
Saint Lawrence,
pray for us.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity,
pray for us.
Saint Agnes,
pray for us.
Saint Gregory,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine,
pray for us.
Saint Athanasius,
pray for us.
Saint Basil,
pray for us.
Saint Martin,
pray for us.
Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Saint Francis Xavier,
pray for us.
Saint John Vianney,
pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena,
pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Jesus,
pray for us.
All holy men and women, saints of God,
pray for us.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from all evil.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from every sin.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from everlasting death.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by your incarnation.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by your death and resurrection.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, deliver us, we pray. Be merciful to us sinners.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bring these chosen ones to new birth through the grace of baptism.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer. Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Of your great love, and send forth the spirit of adoption to create the new peoples, brought to birth for you in the font of baptism, so that what is carried out by our humble service may be brought to fulfillment by your mighty power, through Christ our Lord. O God, who by invisible power accomplish a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit in the first moments of the world's creation hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed great regeneration, so that from the mystery of the one and same element of water would come an end to vice and a beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people, set free from slavery to Pharaoh, would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the water of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection, commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of the life of old may be found worthy to rise to the new life of newborn children through water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, Lord, we pray, come down through your Son into the fullness of this fount, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Springs of water, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Springs of water, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
My dear elect, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God? Renuncien a todas las seducciones del mal para que el pecado no los esclavice. Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Aaron, Angelina, Brandon, Daviana, Dylan, Edna, Edward, Emily, Fernando, Frank, James, Jaden, Juliesi, Kenzie, Chiara, Matteo, Naomi. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Creen en Jesucristo, su Hijo único y Señor nuestro, que nació de la Virgen María, padeció y murió por nosotros, resucitó y está sentado a la derecha del Padre. Sí, creen. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Wonderful, porque this is our faith. Esta es nuestra fe. Esta es la fe de la Iglesia que nos gloriamos de profesar en Jesucristo nuestro Señor. Amen. Aaron Michael, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Blessed be God who chose you in Christ.
Edna Christina, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
¿Cómo te llamas? Dylan, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre y del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who chose you in Christ. Alleluia.
Frank Magnus, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Blessed be God who chose you in Christ. Alleluia.
Mateo Samuel, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who chose you in Christ.
Emily Nicole, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
Fernando Javier, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
Jaden, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
name's Alexander. Yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
Kenzie Maria, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
Angelina Maria, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ.
Jiren Yael, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
From Israel, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
Naomi, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ.
Chiara, io te bautizzo nel nome del Padre, e del Hijo, e dello Spirito Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
Daviana Paulet, io te bautizzo nel nome del Padre, e del Hijo, e dello Spirito Santo.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
Giulesi Rubi, io te bautizzo nel nome del Padre, e del Hijo, e dello Spirito Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ.
Io te bautizzo nel nome del Padre, e del Hijo, e dello Spirito Santo. Amen.
Blessed be God who shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
Dear brothers and sisters, you have become a new creation and enclosed yourself in Christ. Receive this baptismal garment and bring it unstained to the judgment seat of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that you may have everlasting life. Ustedes se han transformado en nuevas criaturas y están revestidos de Cristo. Reciban pues la vestidura bautismal, que ha de llevar limpia de mancha ante el tribunal de nuestro Señor Jesucristo para alcanzar la vida eterna. Godparents, please come forward to give the newly baptized the light of Christ. acérquense padrinos y madrinas para que entreguen a los recién bautizados la luz de Cristo. You have been enlightened by Christ. Walk always as children of the light, and keep the flame of faith alive in your hearts. Ustedes han sido iluminados por Cristo. Caminan siempre como hijos y hijas de la luz, y guarden la llama de la fe viva en su corazón para que puedan salir al encuentro del Señor cuando venga al fin, con todos los santos en la gloria celestial. Amen.
Amen.
My dear newly baptized candidates for confirmation, by your baptism you've been born again in Christ, and you have become members of Christ and of his priestly people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us, the Spirit sent by the Lord upon his apostles at Pentecost and given by them and their successors to the baptized. The promised strength of the Holy Spirit which you are about to receive will make you more like Christ and help you to be witnesses to his suffering, death, and resurrection. It will strengthen you to be active members of the church and to build up the body of Christ in faith and in love. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God the Almighty Father for these his adopted sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life and baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing, conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord. And to Christina, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
God bless you. Dylan, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Amen. La paz contigo. Frank Magnus, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Mateo, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo.
Amén.
Paz contigo. Emily, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo.
Amén.
Paz contigo.
Y con tu espíritu.
Fernando Javier, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo.
Amén.
Paz contigo. Jaden, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo.
Amen.
Paz contigo.
Aaron Michael,
be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
James Alexander, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo. Kenzie Mariet, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo. Angelina, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo. Jaden, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo. Brandon, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo. Naomi, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo.
Con tu espíritu.
Kiara, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo. Daviana Paulette, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo. Lesi, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo. Edward, recibe por este señal el don del Espíritu Santo. Paz contigo.
Shows you in Christ. Alleluia.
John, you guys go out. As we're lighting the candles for the renewal of our baptismal promises, I'd like to recognize on this side people wearing white garments who are members of the First Community of St. Columba's, who have been for years preparing to solemnly renew their baptismal promises through the work of the Neocatechumenal Way, and at the same time carrying the good news to our brothers and sisters. In nombre de la comunidad de la arquidiócesis, yo quisiera felicitar los hermanos y hermanas de la primera comunidad del camino neocatecumenal en la parroquia de San Colomba, que se han preparado durante años para renovar solemnemente en esta noche el compromiso bautismal. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and all his works and promised to serve God in his holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan? Renuncien a todas sus obras and all his empty show. Creen ustedes en Dios, Padre Todopoderoso, Creador del cielo y de la tierra. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Creen en el Espíritu Santo, en la Santa Iglesia Católica, en la comunión de los santos, en el perdón de los pecados, en la resurrección de los muertos, y en la vida eterna. Que Dios Todopoderoso, Padre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, que nos liberó del pecado y nos ha hecho renacer por el agua y el Espíritu Santo, nos conserve con su gracia unidos a Jesucristo nuestro Señor hasta la vida eterna.
Amén.
Alleluia, alleluia.
God has given us a new birth unto a living hope. Let our Easter prayer embrace the needs of the whole human family as we bring our petitions to the altar.
Our response is, Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Father, Pope Francis, bishops, priests, religious, deacons, all those who minister in the church, and for all the Catholic faithful, may our Easter celebration lead us to a deeper commitment to live out our faith by serving God and others. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
Por todos los recién bautizados, para que sigan fielmente a Jesús y mantengan la luz de Cristo viva en sus vidas, oremos al Señor. For all the human family, that Christ's victory over death may bring hope and healing to all who are burdened by poverty, disease, prejudice, and fear. We also pray that children may live and grow in peace, celebrating God's love each day of their life. We pray to the Lord. For todos los aquí reunidos, para que los que hemos sido lavados en las aguas de vida podamos continuar creciendo en Dios y llevar su presencia a todo el mundo. Oremos al Señor. For peace throughout the world, that the risen Lord will give all leaders courage to work for peace in all war-torn areas, and that God may provide all those who struggle for peace and justice a new springtime of faith that will yield an abundant harvest in their efforts. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Por todos aquellos que están lejos de sus hogares en esta Pascua de Resurrección, especialmente todos los cristianos misioneros y miembros de las Fuerzas Armadas, que Dios les proteja y les traiga salvos, oremos al Señor.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater respect and appreciation of human life, that all may recognize God's gift in each human life and nurture that life each day, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Por todos los necesitados, por los pobres, los desamparados y todos los enfermos, para que puedan encontrar al Señor resucitado, el cual les trae esperanza y salud, oremos al Señor.
Risen Lord, hear our fill your church, O God of glory, with the power flowing from Christ's resurrection. Help us to be present in this world as the beginnings of a renewed humanity, redeemed and risen to new life in Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
As our gifts are prepared, we sing God's Right Hand and Holy Arm, as on page 26 of the worship booklet.
God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory. God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory. Christ being raised from the dead shall die no more. Death has no power over him. He lives to God. God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory. God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory.
I seek the living now among the dead. Recall his promise unto you. He lives again, God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory. God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory. Gone is death's victory. Gone is death's sting. God gives to us the victory. Through Christ our Lord, God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory. God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory. Christ being raised from the dead shall die no more. Death has no power over him. He lives to God, God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory. God's right hand and holy arm have won the victory.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all.
Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has been begun in the Paschal mysteries may by the working of your power bring us to the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he destroyed our death, and by rising has restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as there without end they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, and my assistant bishops, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants who have presented your chosen ones for the holy grace of baptism, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred night, in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the most glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Lord Jesus Christ, celebrating the most sacred night of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmans and Damien, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family which we make to you, also for those to whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you've given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. With humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these offerings be brought by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Fieles a la recomendación del Salvador, y siguiendo su divina enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir, Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día. Perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en tentación, y líbranos del mal. Líbranos de todos los males, Señor. Concédenos la paz en nuestros días, para que, ayudados por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres del pecado y protegidos de toda perturbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Señor Salvador Jesucristo.
Tuyo es el reino, tuyo el poder y la gloria, por siempre, Señor.
El Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz les dejo, mi paz les doy. No tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia. Y conforme a tu palabra, concédele la paz y la unidad. Tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
The peace of the Lord. La paz del Señor esté siempre con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Démonos fraternalmente la paz.
Behold the Lamb of God. Este es el Cordero de Dios que quita los pecados del mundo. Dichosos los invitados a la cena del Señor. Señor, yo no soy digno de que entres en mi casa, pero una palabra tuya bastará para sanarme.
As we approach the table of the Lord, we raise our hearts and voices singing Festival Canticle and Christ Be Our Light, as on page 28 of the worship booklet.
This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ the Lamb who was slain, whose blood set us free to be people of God. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Riches, wisdom, and strength, and honor, blessing, and glory are His. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. People of God, and join in the hymn of all creation. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Blessing, honor, glory, and might be to God and the Lamb forever. Amen. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. For the Lamb who was slain has begun His reign. Alleluia. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Mm-hmm. This is the night of new beginnings. This is the night when heaven meets earth. This is the night filled with God's glory, promise of our new birth. Christ be our light, shine in our heart, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather today. This is the night Christ our Redeemer rose from the grave, triumphant and free, leaving the tomb of evil and darkness empty for all to see. Christ be our light, shine in our heart, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Now will the fire kindled in darkness burn to dispel the shadows of night. Star of the morning, Jesus, our Savior, you are the world's true light. Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Sing of the hope deeper than dying. Sing of the power stronger than death. Sing of the love endless as heaven, dawning throughout the earth. Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather
Oremos. Infúndenos, Señor, el espíritu de tu caridad, para que, saciados con los sacramentos pascuales, vivamos siempre unidos en tu amor por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amen.
Before I ask God's blessing, I would like to thank all who worked so hard to make this a beautiful evening. thanking in a special way the catechists, the sisters, the las misioneras franciscanas, y todos los que han preparado esos nuevos bautizados, our new brothers and sisters in Christ. Thank you for saying yes to Jesus, because for us, some of us that have been baptized a long time ago, you help renew in us that great gift that was given to us. Doy gracias a la comunidad, la primera comunidad de San Colomba, con su santísimo párroco. Muy humilde también. Felicidades en llegar a este momento de una renovación solemne. Y ustedes saben que Cristo cuenta con ustedes para llevar su buena nueva. I thank the musicians, our John and the cantors. I thank my brother priests, Father Bismarck, the rector of the cathedral, Father John, his untiring companion. Thank you to the readers and to our servers who seem to get better with each service. Y he esperado a esos últimos momentos para agradecer a los diáconos, porque son por natura muy humildes y no querían. Gracias, Asterio y Tam. Y la buena nueva es que la alegría de Pascua es tan grande que no se puede celebrar en una sola noche. Y vamos a seguir por 50 días. 50 días celebrando y meditando y agradeciendo a Dios por la resurrección de Cristo. Cristo ha resucitado. Aleluya.
Bow your head for God's blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
Que les conceda el premio de la inmortalidad, aquel que los ha redimido para la vida eterna con la resurrección de su unigénito.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
Y la bendición de Dios Todopoderoso, Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo, desciende sobre ustedes y permanezca para siempre.
Amen.
Go in peace, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
We go forth singing Jesus is Risen, as on page 29 of the worship booklet.
Jesus is risen, let us sing. Praise to the ever-living King. Alleluia, alleluia. Praise him in song, ye seraphim. Praise him with joy, ye cherubim. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
most holy day of days, let us together sing his praise. Alleluia, alleluia. Raise joyful voices to the sky. Sing out ye heavens in reply. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. To God the Father let us sing, to God the Son, our risen King. Alleluia, alleluia. And equally let us adore the Holy Spirit evermore.